Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by Makerdemy. This is Tejaswini and I am a part of the instructor team at Makerdemy. In this episode, we will understand how to decode an ESP32-S2 microcontroller datasheet. In an earlier episode, we have already done a side-by-side comparison of the ESP32-S2 with the normal ESP32. You can check that out from the link given in the description. Before delving into the decoding process of the ESP32-S2 datasheet, let us first understand what a datasheet is and what it is used for. A datasheet is a document providing the specifications and details of a particular product. At first glance, looking at the datasheet of a microcontroller may seem overwhelming, given that it is filled with numerous details and diagrams. But it is more used as a reference than a manual for using the microcontroller or the device. Its function is similar to that of using a dictionary to learn a particular language. One does not necessarily have to learn the entire datasheet to work with the microcontroller. Rather, one just needs to learn how to use and refer to it to understand the microcontroller or the device such that it suits their application. Let us now begin decoding the ESP32-S2 using its datasheet. The ESP32-S2 is a low-power Wi-Fi system-on-chip microcontroller module. This module was developed and released in September 2019 by the Espressif Systems Company. The prominent features of the module are that its Wi-Fi is IEEE 802.11b/g/n compliant and supports 20 MHz and 40 MHz bandwidth in 2.4 GHz band. It uses a Extensa single-core 32-bit microprocessor with 128 KB ROM and 320 KB SRAM. The SoC consists of advanced peripheral interfaces and offers secure, cost-effective, and power-efficient performance. It is widely used in several IoT and low-power applications such as smart homes, wearable electronics, industrial automation, and more. The block diagram describes the various sections in the SoC, including the main CPU, Wi-Fi, RF, RTC, cryptographic hardware, acceleration, and the various peripherals and sensors. The ESP32-S2 datasheet primarily covers three topics: the pin definitions of the microcontroller, the functional description, and finally, its electrical characteristics. Let us first look at the pin definitions of the microcontroller. The ESP32-S2 family pin layout is given. It is a 56-pin integrated circuit, among which 43 pins are programmable GPIOs. The other pins include the analog power supply pins, the RF input and output pin, and the external crystal output pin. The descriptions of the pins along with their functions and power domain specifications are listed in the form of a table. This table also tells us which of the GPIO pins are analog pins, and which of them are digital pins, and more such details of the functions of each pin. While this section defines the pins present in the core chip of the SoC, a pinout diagram of the ESP32-S2 module will be useful in locating the pins on the SoC module as a whole. Moving on to the functional description part of the datasheet, this part covers the functions of the ESP32-S2, such as the CPU architecture and memory units, system clocks, analog and digital peripherals, details of the power management unit, timers and watchdogs, and the peripheral pin configurations. The ESP32-S2 family makes use of a low-power Extensa 32-bit LX7 microprocessor. Some of the features of this microprocessor are that it supports clock frequency up to 240 MHz, unbuffered GPIO instructions, and a 32-bit multiplier and 32-bit divider. The internal memory units of the ESP32-S2 include the following: 128 KB ROM for core and booting functions, 320 KB of on-chip SRAM for storing data and instructions, 8 KB of SRAM in RTC, also known as RTC fast memory, and also RTC slow memory, where both of them can retain data in deep sleep mode. The firmware also allows the mapping of external RAM and flash memory into the CPU address space. The microcontroller also has an independent instruction cache and data cache that have a configurable size of 8 KB or 16 KB. The system clocks include the CPU clock, the RTC clock, and audio PLL clock. The analog peripherals in the SoC include two 12-bit ADCs, two 10-bit DACs, temperature sensor with a range of minus 20 degrees to plus 110 degrees, and also 14 capacitive sensing GPIOs acting as a touch sensor. The digital peripherals include the GPIO pins, serial peripheral interface, that is SPI, LCD interface, UART, I2C interface, I2S interface, camera interface, infrared remote controller, LED PWM and USB 1.1 OTG. The microcontroller has a 2.4 GHz transmitter and receiver for its Wi-Fi. For low power applications, the controller uses advanced power management technologies and can be made to switch between various power modes such as active mode, modern sleep mode, light sleep mode, deep sleep mode, hibernation mode. Next comes the electrical characteristics of the ESP32-S2. The absolute maximum ratings give the minimum and maximum operating voltages and temperature range of the microcontroller. The recommended operating conditions give the details of the recommended supply voltage levels. In this case, the input voltage range is from 3 volts to 3.6 volts, and the recommended input voltage is 3.3 volts. The maximum voltage that can be tolerated by the GPIO pins and the maximum current that can be drawn from them is 3.3 volt and 12 milliampere respectively. It must be ensured that the microcontroller supply meets these requirements, else it may get damaged. The current drawn by the ESP32-S2 board varies from 1 microampere to 310 milliampere. Of course, the current drawn can vary significantly depending on the application, based on which it can be switched to various power modes as mentioned earlier. The electrical characteristics in the datasheet also cover AC-DC characteristics of the controller in detail. Finally, the packaging information of the ESP32-S2 is given in the form of a diagram, which is useful when designing or printing PCB boards using this microcontroller. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.